Steve, can you take over for me? More bread, Santa?
Don't mind about you.
You got a name, Santa? I know the names of everyone here. We're like a big family. My name's McCall. Pleased to meet you, mister.
Riley.
Riley? Hmm. That's an Irish name.
Sound a bit Irish yourself.
I was born here. My father was from Glasgow. I suppose I came back here to look for my roots.
Good idea, kid. Everyone in the world should know who they are.
You got a first name?
Doghouse.
An ex-con, are you? There's no shame in that.
No place I could rest my head for a day or two.
Not too pricey.
I think the best place for you is Mrs. Napier's guest house. I know it's late, but she'll be okay. Here's a wee map and the address. You can't miss it. It's just around the corner. Tell her that Lauren sent you.
Lauren. Lauren McCall.
Merry Christmas.
Suddenly, the world felt alive again, even in this outfit. It felt good to be wearing a jacket that didn't tie up the back. Whatever they'd been using at the funny farm to spike my food had done bad things to my brain box.
Mrs. Napier, ma'am.
Santa! Shouldn't you be coming down the chimney?
Sorry to get you out of your bed.
Oh, it wasn't in my bed. I was just stuffing the cat.
Oh. Don't you mean the turkey?
No, the cat. It died yesterday. Oh. Well, come in, come in. Oh, it's nice to see you. Christmas just isn't the same without the White Heather Club.
Lauren recommended you.
Oh, did she? Sweet, sweet girl. Murderers, rapists. I've had them all. Let me show you to your room, Mr. Mr.
No names, Mrs. Napier. Safer for both of us. It's lovely. It's a good mattress. If there are bugs in this bed, you must be paying them hush money. Oh.
You'll have had your tea, but I do serve breakfast, of course. Porridge or capers.
That'd be lovely.
You'll be needing a change of clothes. You'll not have much chance of getting a job dressed like that. Now, don't be embarrassed, but my late husband's apparel has proved useful before for some of the boys who pass through here. We'll sort you out in no time.
There's still one thing you haven't quite made clear yet, Dr. Branch.
Oh, what's that?
Why does Clooney call the man he has to find the fat man? Is it because his father was fat? Is that it?
No, Sergeant. The fat man was a bad guy in an old movie.
The Maltese Falcon.
Correct. But there's something I haven't told you yet. The most important piece of the jigsaw.
What's that?
Francis Clooney suffers from an extreme and unusual delusion that makes his behavior rather...
odd.
Unpredictable.
What kind of delusion?
Sometimes he thinks he's Arnold Schwarzenegger. Occasionally Cagney, sometimes Lacey. To my certain knowledge, he's been Sean Connery twice. But mostly, he thinks he's Humphrey Bogart.
Never mind, son. You grow into it.
He's looking at you, Mrs. Napier.
There, you see? I knew you would suit it. You get a job with that outfit, no problem, son.
Thanks, Mrs. Ann. That's perfect.
Jones!
Hey! Hit that door!
The fat man's goons! I don't know how they found me.
What's going on?
Can you get me a piece?
Of course, but you don't want to spoil your breakfast.
What?
I can give you a piece on jam, a piece on marmalade, or a piece on butter. I bet a nice jelly piece would be your favourite. Am I right?
By now, I had her pegged as a little crazy.
I'd do a very nice class of sandwich, I assure you.
For Pete's sake, I mean a rod, a heater.
But,
You'll have to spell it out. I mean a gun.
Oh, might it be? Is there going to be a shooting?
Not if I can help it, Mrs. N.
I'm afraid I can't help you there.
Relax. I'll take care of that little problem.
That night, I slept better than I had in years. For once, I didn't dream of the old boneyard and the angel with one wing. Instead, I dreamt of a different kind of angel, and this one was holding a soup ladle. Next morning, breakfast found me still thinking about the luscious-lipped Lauren McCall. Even in our brief acquaintance, she's the closest I've got to a friend in this town. Breaks your heart, doesn't it?
Occasional showers may fall with snow on high ground, and in some areas of the west. But some parts of Scotland at least are enjoying.
No, mister. Porridge or kippers?
Kippers, please.
Criminals known as the Happy Gang, who carried out several daily raids in Scotland this year, were struck again. And this time their haul could be enormous. They've emptied several safety deposit boxes full of priceless jewellery and cash from shops in the Argyle Arcade in Glasgow City Centre. Now we go over to our reporter on the spot, who's talking to the police officer in charge of the inquiry.
Detective Sergeant Muir, is this the work of the Happy Gang?
Yes, sir, that's right, the Happy Gang. Undoubtedly, they've left their calling card.
So surely there must be a mastermind behind this, a Mr. Big.
We call him Mr. Happy, Edith. Undoubtedly, there's a sinister and sophisticated criminal mind at work here.
You're in luck, mister. You have two extra. There's plenty keepers now the cat stayed.
A dangerous inmate escape from Spinbinny Mental Hospital in Glasgow. Francis Forbes Clooney, aged 40, made his escape disguised as Father Christmas. Police say on no account should the public approach this man, as he is extremely dangerous and may be armed. And on a lighter note.
Sometimes I think the television's too noisy in the morning, don't you?
Oh, yes.
Madness is relative, isn't it? Most of my relatives are. Eat them up now. You're a growing man.
This is the last of them.
That night, as I head back to the soup kitchen, the rain comes down like happy hour in a Coney Island car wash. What do I care? Here I am in a European city of culture in pursuit of a beautiful dame. And I know she'll be waiting. I can smell the lentils from the sidewalk.
Excuse me, sir. You haven't have any spare cash, mister?
Sorry, bud, I'm kind of broke myself. Only got a couple of dimes. Pennies, you know.
Well, that wouldn't be enough anyway. I need about 20 quid for a concert ticket.
I was stuck with a full story, and I knew it.
Do go on, compadre.
Well, just want the price of one seat, you know. I mean, I don't need a royal box or anything too fancy, you know. Upper circle. Restricted view.
I'll let him babble on as I cast around for Lips McCall.
Just that there's all these new gigs coming on, you know. A new production of Rigoletto for the Scottish Opera. Set in Belfast. Oh, and a new Swan Lake with real water. Johnny, mister, see if I don't get to see one of these. I don't know if I'll survive.
You're a culture junkie.
But I blame the fat man.
The fat man?
Pavarotti. It all started with his concerts. And that led to the cassettes and then the albums and then the T-shirts. Not to mention the pirate tapes of the World Cup theme. Now, you name it. And there was Mayor.
I thought there might be.
There was the Sinatra Shambles. And the Bolshoi Ballyhoo. And before you could say, crush bar at the interval, the only place we could afford to get into was the bankruptcy courts. And it was your big fat Bampot Pavarotti that started all the rot.
Yeah? Do you know any other fat men in this town? Getting fat at other people's expense, if you take my meaning.
Mister, this tune's full of fat men, thin men, tall men, wee men, hard men. I'm just medium-sized and soft. You sure you couldn't spare me 200 quid?